Oi, I'm back. I have tea. I'm not going to start to my Coca-Cola. I do have a bottle of water though, so we're all start to up. My glasses are wonky. My soundproofing has yet again fallen off the wall. Ow!
Right. Oh no, that's the wrong angle.
Hello. Are you ready? I'm not. Right, okay, let's continue on with what I was doing here. We just need to cure these patients in the DNA lab and keep on upping our diagnosis ability so we can churn through. So we can get patients into these treatment rooms where they will inevitably die because we're not working on treatment at all. But yeah, I just started training on my GPs, which is why we've got no GPs in the offices. So those queues are going to go up a little bit. Handy little bottleneck though, to be honest. I am clumsy today. I'm hitting everything. Give it a few of my months and Tasha's not going to let me go up the stairs with a hot drink anymore. Can't be trusted. Can't be trusted. Sort of this out, God. Oh, it's an interesting game to stream because it takes so much of your cognitive load. Aaron has the Switch. He has Breath of the Wild, Mario Odyssey, and Stardew Valley. What's your favourite? The one that's your go-to. Man, I want to play Breath of the Wild again.
Has taken the foolish decision to check himself into one of Holistic's nature communes. Call me old-fashioned, but patients are supposed to be treated by doctors in hospitals, not have leaves rubbed on them by druids.
Someone important is arriving.
Right, okay, what was the thing? And also, you know, I've got to say, over the past few weeks, I've had a fantastic couple of weeks. Got engaged to Tasha, which is probably the main event, of course. It was really sunny during my week and a half off. I couldn't have planned a better period of time off. But because it was really sunny, which meant we could spend time in the garden or just do pretty much whatever I want. Apart from the, if you imagine our house, the master bedroom's on the third floor, which is in the roof, like a little loft. It's a loft conversion, but it was built that way, you know, it was never a loft. But that's our master bedroom, so during the day, the sun just bakes. Like, there's no front of a room for the master bedroom. It gets baked from both sides, effectively. So by the time it comes to night time, it's about 30 degrees centigrade in the bedroom. It's about 30 degrees in the bedroom, so during the heat wave, we could not, I repeat, could not sleep in the master bedroom during the heat wave. So what we did is we got the spare mattress that we had in our second bedroom and dragged that into the living room and slept down there for a week. Which is actually kind of it was a change of scenery, which wasn't so bad, but the cool temperatures meant that we got actually a decent amount of sleep rather than sleeping in the roasting bedroom. And of course, I've gone back to work now and the Olympics have just started, so I've got stuff to have on in the background whilst I'm working, which is fantastic. I had this swimming on today. Oh, Bicklesworth.
I will give you two rather different points of view on a contentious subject. So, for example, view A could be, this is a rather fine idea for a segment, whereas view B would then be, this segment is an embarrassing waste of time. Stay tuned for more of these controversial debates next week.
I love Pickle Swift. He doesn't care. Enticed as it was because sleeping now. So it was because we've got like a corner sofa in our living room. And the way I sleep in, I slept in like the little nestle where the corner of the sofa was. So it was like really nice and cozy for me. And the only problem is we have a cat litter downstairs as well. And we have an open doors policy in this house. But by when I say we, I mean the cats have an open door policy in this house, because if you shut a door, they will let the entire street know about it by scratching the carpet up and meowing the house down. But with this open door policy, we have the living room, a little bit of hallway with two doors on either side. Imagine like an airlock. And then the kitchen. In the kitchen is where the cats do their poopy. And normally, right before I went to sleep, about 11 o'clock at night, one of the cats drops what can only be described as mustard gas bombs in the kitchen. Like, he knew how to stink up the place. So that was the downside of sleeping downstairs. And as you might imagine, during a heatwave, the turds can be quite potent. Congratulations! Your hospital has been awarded a 1-star rating by the 2-point health ministry. In truth, we fear that nothing could survive in the grounds that you currently occupy. So it's here that you're not just alive, but managing to treat people is, certainly, gravy on the proverbial goose. Continue to play with fire for more rewards, or flee that unstable place and expand your organization. We shall continue on. Right, it now cares about cure rates. Right, before I progress any further, I'm just going to go see what upgrades I can do. Oh yes, the Olympic Games of choice for me are the swimming. I've been feverishly watching the swimming. Like, Tasha's been struggling to get the telly off of me whilst I watch the swimming on TV. Like, I've watched pretty much every single session. And then once I've done with that, I stick on the skateboarding. Because I think those are the easy sports to watch in the background. Because the commentators are really good as well. They like keep you up to date with what's going on. Really handily. Now, do I have any staff at new training? No. Look at this. Clockwork Hospital. And the other one's an absolute shit show. That's gonna take forever. Right, I now have five-star research is brilliant. My GPs are nearly getting there as well. This is what I need in my new hospital. Fully upgraded machines and just diagnosis where they all need to go to one room. The problem with this though is this hospital is expensive to run. Like, I think, I say that I'm a millionaire. But you can see here, 90,000 to 90,000. Barely breaking even, it goes up and down. Can't even keep a patient count up because we're just treating them so fast. Alright, there we go. And we also got some more kudosh. Alright, back to meltdowns. Back to hell! I say that, it's not doing so bad, it's just the... Now that we need to be upgrading machines and such. Maintenance announcement. Automated snack machines need restocking. Yeah, I can get this drug mix upgrade. I've got two upgrades there, two upgrades here. And then we can buy some more machinery if we need to. It's a patient home and we'll promote you. Actually, is there any training we can do? Oh shit, how much does that cost? Ooh! 40,000 doll hairs. Yikes. That's okay. My money's slowly going up. And reputation should be increasing now because we've reset how much it costs for everything. That means our profit will go down a bit until our reputation goes up again. Right, 26 patients is not a lot. Everything seems to be going a bit more smoothly though. Considering an extra 10 patients and we was flooded in here. Yeah, diagnosis 100% straight away, so pretty much all the pharmacy stuff's getting sorted out immediately. I don't have the money to upgrade these machines. And I'm not taking out a loan because that kills the hospital. In fact, I don't think I need to worry about doing anything else now in terms of training for the moment. Welcome to six. I can focus on getting these machines upgraded. Harrison Wolf, Two Point County's most enthusiastic radio DJ. I'm just so excited to be here. One thing that's frustrating me about this game actually is this number 7 down here. 7 new levels. Is that, that's not going to go away until I buy the DLC, is it? Oh, you lecherous curs over at Two Point Studio. You know how to pull on my irritated strings. Right, God, we've got so many staff promotions. I mean, I don't want to get a fracture ward because a fracture ward, you need a whole building for the damn thing. Actually, we don't have any snack machines over here. Let's get some. I'm just essentially filling this with random plant in the hallway, which I don't have anywhere else in the hospital. But yeah, I put two bins down and then the entire hospital needs my attention. Yeah, we all know someone with that in the bloody ID tag, don't we? Actually, why don't I build a deluxe clinic? You hear that sound? That's the sound of people in power getting nervous. They want us to stay quiet, see? But we're not gonna do that. This thing's gonna blow up any minute, and this mic here is the match that lights the fuse. 45. For the weather. Let's do that. This is gonna send me back into bankruptcy, but... the more diagnosis, the better. Because I don't want this going back to the way it was. That's going to go back into like minus 20,000 or something. Having said that, though, is... like, the only thing I'm lacking here is just more treatment rooms. I'm going to put a deluxe clinic in here eventually, just... Just because I think it's cheap enough and it's 3x3. And then that's one more message prompt that I don't need to worry about. And thankfully my reputation's going back up. So I'm now under 20 patients, which is not a lot in the slightest. Right, how's my illnesses doing? What's killing my cure rate? The ward, interesting. And the DNA lab. I just need to train the treatment staff as... I mean, across the board, it's just averagely bad. Yeah, it just needs overall increased treatment skill of all the staff, really. Oh yeah, yeah. Right, I think I'll get some better ward nurses. Wait, I've only got level 2 discharger, really? Thought I could give up to 3. Really? Do I need to upgrade it before I can proceed? No, maybe I just... Oh, maybe I get it for getting a level 2 hospital. Maybe that's a reward. Oh, no, here we go. It shows you how much I know about this game, isn't it? I am by no stretch of words an expert. It's just 40 odd patients and not a problem. And then again, I do have 1, 2, 3, 4. It's like 1 GP's office per 10 patients in the hospital. 3 general diagnosis. 3 cardiologies. I've got 4 GP's office and 3 of each diagnosis room. Maybe that's the sweet spot. Right, well. Yeah, give that diagnosis 5. Yeah, see, this hospital's been going for so long, my price reputation. I think that's gotta be a bug. That's broken. It even says it in overview. I'm surprised that's not been picked up on. That's quite a glaring issue. Who knows? I'll fly it up on a forum, but I'll probably just get shouted down. It's been there since day one. It's because you're shit at managing your prices. I'm sorry. I thought it was a problem with the game. Tapers pushover. Right, is that another 5,000 run? Yeah. Well, how fast it goes up with 5 5-star researchers in a 5-star room. It's absurd. And the other guy couldn't even do it that quick. By himself. Level 1 researcher, just nothing moved. And it just kind of drives home how important it is, though, that particularly for cure rate and diagnosis efficiency, just upgrade the machines. It's a tough decision to make, because particularly the start hospital, you're going to have like 1 diagnosis room. Once you upgrade it, the bottleneck, the queue just gets bigger and bigger. I find you've just got to rip that band-aid off really quick, though. Just do it, and then the queue will eventually go down. There you go. Right, what was I gonna do? Back to meltdowns. I'm surprised that meltdowns is actually a cold hospital. I'd have expected it to be at least a warm hospital, given its proximity to a nuclear power station. Particularly one that's apparently majorly radioactive. What do I know? Right. Oh god, that was no revenue at all. I guess we didn't do any treatments that month. I wanna see what this does. Oh! Does it do much of anything? Actually, whilst this is ticking over, we don't really need to do that much. No, it costs money. I can just go check what the illnesses are. Verbal diarrhea, we've read this, haven't we? The disease people can't stop talking about. Verbal diarrhea spreads fast and can be heard for miles. Misery guts. Chronic grumpiness due to nihilistic semicolon. Bed face. A quite alarming contortion of the face. Caused by sleeping at a strange angle, face down on the pillow, I imagine. Doctors recommend always using a bed protractor to monitor your sleeping angles. Alright, I was busy reading, but we'll see what I've got here. Handy cash injection for winning those. Chest infection, a condition that causes hijinks and general buffoonery. Could also be called twitch infection. Escape clowns must have their sense of humor completely excised to prevent a future relapse. Shock horror. We've read lycanthropy, right? Once thought to be extinct, lycanthropy is making a comeback in dangerous forests across the land. Sufferers get it from direct exposure to light from a full moon, or possibly from door handles. Research is going on to discover which. Shock horror. This is what happens if you simultaneously put a knife in a toaster and a fork in a power socket. wow. Monobrow. Extreme hair growth caused by excessive consumption of both highbrow and lowbrow entertainment. Must be carefully removed and placed in a secure container to prevent it from escaping. Right, I do actually need to start building some of these rooms because we're just letting money walk out the door. How much is an injection run?
Stay tuned for the weather. Regular listeners will know that's code for Harrison Wolf's got some big news. That's right. I just found out last week's fireworks were staged to send messages that can be seen from outer space. So keep an eye out for any unusual tourists.
Right, cool. And this should lower the amount of... This should increase our money by a little bit because the injection room is one that's highly sought after, apparently. There we go. Right, cool. Back to laughing at the illnesses. Denim jeans. Skin has the appearance of denim. Causes a... oh, boy. What are Mario's overalls made of? Denim. I'll see myself out, shall I? See you. Causes a great deal of irritation. Mainly due to the time it takes to dry after a shower. Yeah, that's true. believed to be caused by Bungle's genetically engineered genes, which have since been recalled. Humerus injury. Patients are really not amused by this injury of the upper arm. And lightheadedness. The patients are notable due to their bulbous heads. Oh yeah, I need a treatment nurse. Do I not have a treatment nurse? There we go. Wait, what happened here? Oh, now we need a psychiatry. Right. How's diagnosis doing? I don't think that's a problem anymore, is it? No. Right, I'm just gonna see if there's any better doctors. Not really. Yeah, I'll put my eggs in that basket with a doctor with the, give him treatment too. I'd get rid of motivation and heartbeat if I could, but don't think that's a possibility in this game. Alright, we'll get that discharger upgraded. And then we'll upgrade the job master up to 3. That'll give us 6 out of 10. My tea's nearly at the prime temperature. Good tea. When did I go on break? I don't know how long ago it was. See, this is the thing, I started my stream like at
A friend of mine got me a working holiday at Mary Dung Farm for my birthday. I say friend, but I haven't spoken to him since. Anyways, this next song is for anyone who's had to mix up a batch of hog slop.
What was I gonna say? When did I start streaming? Come back off break. Because I started my stream about 10 minutes early. Well, I say started, I had it going like just between 1:45 and 10:02. So instead of having live for just 1 hour 55 minutes, so I'm thinking in about 15 minutes I'll go for another break, but that feels like really quick. I don't know. Alright, what I'm going to do is I'm going to lift this training room and put it over here. Actually, I just saw a GP's office ping up there as having a full queue. Like, so what I'm eventually going to do is... Oh, I can't even upgrade any machines because we're hemorrhaging money again. What I was going to say I was going to do is build a deluxe lab in there because that's a 3x3 room. What's this? 79% would still fail. That's harsh. I should probably take on the shotgun emergency so the free money. Man, $40,000. It's okay, because dead people do pay money still. It just affects my cure rate. I wish it was an automatic send patient home button. Then again, I wouldn't know what rooms are in demand. Yeah. Yeah, we'll get them DNA patients in here. Pump them through, get some money. There we go. Man, it annoys me that it keeps sending patients for which I can't cure. Yeah, let's get that upgraded. I'm just pause it. I want to grab all the success. 55%. Poor guy. Upgrade should help though. Get it up to like 75% cure rate, I think. Wait, where's the doctor gone? Oh, what a jerk. Just goes on break. Time is of the essence. Yeah. Well, he's got a lot of work to do when he gets back. That's all I'm saying about that. You know, the thing is, that guy going on break, why is it saying that he can't find anywhere to put things in the bin? There's bins everywhere. Got hit. The thing is, him going on break, though, it just eats into my profits. It's the costliest break ever. It cost me like 50,000. Well, I've got one objective done. Injection room, calling nurse. Well, he's not failed any of the actual emergencies yet. Pretty handy success chance, though. Alright, after this I need to check which upgrade this. And then after that I'm going to check which members of my staff need treatment skill increase. Or which illnesses are causing me headaches. Cool. 5 out of 5 patients, that's quite handy. Alright, decision rash. The injection room's causing problems. The DNA lab's improving. Need to get better in the ward as well. Let's see if I can start building my ward stuff. It's looking for work. What do I mean looking for work? Is no one in the ward? No one is rocking up for the ward, actually. Alright, let's see if we can do the more popular ones. Yeah, send him on training, right? There's a massive queue. What's the worst that could happen? My profits! I mean, I could get this doctor, but he's just going to kill them all and smash my cure rate to pieces. They can wait, it's okay. An electrical storm. Not so good if you're hooked up to any equipment right now, but great conditions for reanimating monsters assembled from body parts. You know, whilst I autopiloted, I drank all my tea, and because I was autopiloting, I forgot that I drank my tea, so now I have no tea. I do that every day. My life is a roller coaster of highs and lows, evidently. Right. How long is it going to take for that treatment to get done? Shouldn't take too long. I think treatment 3 is enough to... Yeah, god bloody hell, he goes and it's... treatment 3 should be enough to get my staff skill high enough. Just this motivation is pointless. Increased speed and efficiency, actually, if I had to have a dump stat on one, it would have been that one, efficiency. Do I have 2 treatment doctors? Where is this guy? Wait, I sold my research lab, didn't I? Yeah, it's not that guy. He's costing money. Dying because they're so ill. Go 90 days without a death. They think we are in a hospital. Watch, this guy goes straight on break. No, his energy's max. Brilliant. Yeah, that should boost our money. We've got plenty of people to come into these rooms. My cure rate is abysmal. I just want to stand and watch where my deaths are coming from. 55%. It's definitely not the DNA lab because I've been watching it and it's actually kind of handy, the cure rate. Is it literally just the injection room? Or literally anyone that goes in here. We're close to award season. It is a jabby jab room. So what we're going to do is... Nurse Aubrey de la Grotte. You have killed. You have been useless for far too long. Right, what's Layla Rhymes and Holly Ocean do? Right, Ward and Holly Ocean works in the pharmacy. So yes, they can have treatment as well, actually, because you can only get one pharmacy management. So literally all the level 1 nurses are going to get treatment 1. For all 4 of these. Do I have the money for this? Yeah, where's he? Working in the shock clinic. DNA lab. Looking for work. Yeah. Didn't have to pay a single penny on that. Right, and I am actually going to go get the Deluxe Lux Clinic. Wherever it may be, it's... There we go. Deluxe Lux. Why did I call it Deluxe Lux? God damn screen shaking about. I'm trying to put down a fire extinguisher. No, it's not centered. Things in way. Well, rip. Just brush it under the rug, guys. It's okay. No one ever look into this room ever again. Got 4 out of 7 patients. So that's doing a bit of badness as well. What is it? 99% chance. Sending people home doesn't affect my cure rate, does it? It shouldn't, because I didn't actually attempt the cure. Right, is that other staff that just got... I've got all my staff are getting promoted that have just been... Right, I'll let them burn the queues down, and then I'll pull them back in to do more training. And then once we've got 2-star hospital, I imagine we'll be able to move over to another room and then just get all the stuff that it's telling me to put in. Clown clinic, upgrade that twice. I think I might need another one of these elixirs though. It's a very busy room. Alright, let's get these nurses back in here. Right, how am I doing on patients actually? 32 patients and the diagnosis flaw is actually doing okay. No, the last thing that DNA room needs is more patients going to it. I am going to need another building before long. Alright, what's killing me still? Well, I'm gonna have to bite the bullet and get one of these fracture wards. But that's just gonna smash my cure rate down, because these are generally like the worst ones as far as cure rate goes. Denim jeans, injection room's killing me. Even pharmacy, yikes. That's okay, because once these guys are done, it should be a bit better for us. I was hoping to have a 2-star hospital by the time I went on break, but... C'est la vie, I suppose. Right, would any of these buildings are really oddly designed, aren't they? Oh bother, so many of them. No, poor guy's struggling so much. How's his energy like? Right, what do we keep seeing? Clown clinic, really, isn't it?
Feeling ill, the last thing you want to do is pump your body full of cheap artificial medicine. So stay at a holistics hospital, where our natural remedies are so expensive, they just have to be good for you. Holistics, where you can only hope it sticks.
Serving 2 Point County.
This is 2 Point Radio.
Oh, I love this game. It never takes anything too seriously. It's so expensive, it has to work, right?
Hello?
Right, let's get all this set up then. Whoa! This janitor really wanted to come and upgrade this machine. It was like, no. Right, and I should probably purchase another janitor, actually. Yep, let's get that emergency going. Give us a bit of a cash injection. Wait, what? It's a nurse that comes in here, isn't it? Yeah. Which means I'm probably going to want to hoist these doctor's rooms over here and move a clown clinic over there. I've got two doctor's rooms and a shit ton of nurse rooms. I want the doctors to stay in one room and nurses in another, treatment nurses. Right, let me just shift this about. Bear with me while I do this. Right, nurse. Doctor. Yep. Ooh. Right, and I'll put a leaflet stand there while I'm at it. There you go. Where do I want to put my 3x3s? I'm going to put the toilet along here, I think. Speaking of. There you go, and I'll just put the windows down there. Although, there's going to be another 3x3 room there, I'd imagine, so. Could snug the staff room in there, I suppose. No, that might work. I can stick some 3x3 rooms down there. Yep. We shall do it this way. This is a bit of a convoluted mess now. Right, any more doctor's rooms over here? No. And I shall now sort out the hallway. Stop going to my hospital with your broken bones. Is it happening again? Right, there we go. Right, and that's got a big queue because it's dealing with the emergency. And this has got a big queue because it's just a Helixer room. He is working at it, though. It's because when he goes on break, it goes up and it goes down again. Right, okay. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to go and take a quick break. And when I come back, we'll see if we can get this hospital up to 2-star and beyond. So I'll be back in a few minutes, guys.